Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial on Syncfusion React TreeView. In this video, I will show you how to display hierarchical list of items in a tree structure. You can load data on demand, select multiple items using checkboxes, edit nodes, and drag and drop items inside the TreeView component. Now, I am going to create my project with the help of Create React App Toolchain, which installs the latest version of React and React DOM, as well as React scripts. I will view and edit my code using Visual Studio Code and view the output on one of the supported browsers. To create a new React project, I need to install the Create React app globally on my machine using the command npm install -g create react app. As I have already installed it, I am skipping that step here. Now, let me create a new React project using the command create react app project name. I want to create a React app with TypeScript, so let me add --template TypeScript with the existing command and named my project TreeView component. This will create an empty React application with no Syncfusion packages. I will navigate to the newly created application folder to start using the TreeView component within this empty application. I install the navigations package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2react-navigations --save. This command will install the TreeView component along with its subcomponent packages. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready. The first thing I need to do here is to open the app.tsx file and import the TreeView component from the ej2 React Navigations package. Next, I will replace the default code and add the React TreeView component within the render method of the React component. Next, I open the index.tsx and import the register license from the Syncfusion ej2 base package. Then, I register the Syncfusion React trial license key by using the register license method. The Syncfusion React license key registration is applicable from the release 2022 Volume 1. Next, I define the CSS for the TreeView. I can either import the React TreeView component CSS in the app.css file or refer the CDN link in the index.html file. Now, to make it simple, I choose the second option. So, let me open the index.html file and refer the CDN link inside the head section, which includes the combined CSS references of all the essential JS2 React components. Now, to populate the data source, I first create an object named hierarchical data and assign an array of objects with ID and name fields. Here, I have defined the ID field to set a unique ID for the node and name field to display the TreeView node's text. Then, I define a variable, datasource fields, and assign the hierarchical data object to the data source property. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped. So, define the properties, ID and text, and map the fields, ID and name, respectively. Now, I will assign this data source fields variable to the fields property of the React TreeView component. Let me save the application and run my application with the command npm start. This will start the development server and automatically reload the page anytime when I edit my project. Now, as you can see, the TreeView component shows the items. Next, I will show how to add sub-nodes to the main nodes. To do that, within this hierarchical data variable, let me add one more field, subchild, to every parent node object, and define the fields, ID and name with appropriate values. Here, this ID field sets a unique ID for the subnode and name to display the TreeView subnode's text. Then, I will assign this subchild field to the child property of the TreeView fields. Look at the output page now. When expanding the node, the corresponding subnodes are also displayed. Suppose I want to add subnodes for these program files, users, and Windows items. Then, I will define another field, subchild, within this parent node, and assign an array of objects with fields, ID and name with appropriate values. As I said before, this ID field sets a unique ID for the subnode and name to display the TreeView subnode's text. See the TreeView component now, the program files, users and Windows subnodes are displayed while expanding the nodes. Notice here, the nodes are collapsed initially. Suppose I want to expand them, then I need to set the expanded field to true to expand the TreeView nodes. Here, I am going to expand the local disk C item and its subitems, so I have defined expanded field for these nodes. Looking at the TreeView component now, the subnodes of the first node are expanded initially. So far, we have seen how to bind the hierarchical data as local JSON data to the TreeView component. Next, I will show you how to bind a remote data source to the component. This remote data source contains self-referential data. Let's have a look at this self-referential example data to understand its structure. You can see the objects have two additional properties, parent ID and hasChildren. This hasChildren property indicates whether a node has child nodes or not. The parent ID property maps the appropriate parent node to its child node. As I am going to bind the remote data source to the TreeView component that returns self-referential data, I need to map both the parent ID and hasChildren properties. To bind the remote data, I am going to use Syncfusion's Data Manager library. This data manager acts as a gateway between the TreeView component and data source and uses queries to interact with both local and remote data sources. As a first step, I import the data manager and the required adapter from its Syncfusion EJ2 data package. Then, I define the data manager with its properties like URL, adapter, and cross-domain. In the URL, I will be using the already available remote URL service, which will retrieve the list of data through post-action and bind the resultant data to the React TreeView. Also, I have set OData v4 adapter here, as the URL is assigned to the existing OData service. The cross-domain option is set to true to allow the cross-origin domain request. Then, I need to write a query to fetch the data. I define a variable, data query of type query. I have used select query to get the parent node data. Next, I will define one more variable, subnode data query to get child node data. I also need to import this query class from the Syncfusion data package to access it. For this remote data source, I need to map the appropriate data source fields. So, let me define an object named remote data fields and assign the remote data source object to the data source property and map the fields employee ID to ID property and first name to text property. Then, I will define hasChildren property with the value employee ID field to check whether the parent node have child items or not. If the employee ID has child items, it will be displayed when expanding the items. Next, I will proc to map the child node fields. I add the child property and assign remote data source to the data source property, order ID field to the ID property, and ship name to the text property. Next, the parent ID should be mapped for the child items. Therefore, I define the parent ID property and set the employee ID field to specify that the employee ID is the parent to the child items. Also, I need to assign these query variables to the query property of the TreeView fields. And finally, I will set this remote data source field to the fields property of the TreeView component. In the output, you can see where the TreeView component displays the remote data source items and its subitems. Notice here, I can select only one item. To select multiple items, define a Boolean variable, enable multi-selection with the value true. Now, I assign this variable to the allow multi-selection property within this TreeView code. Look at the TreeView component, I can select multiple items. Next, I will show you how to enable checkboxes for these items and its subitems. To do that, first I define a Boolean variable, enable checkbox, and set its value to true. Then, assign this variable to the showCheckbox property. Now, you can see the TreeView nodes displayed with checkboxes. Here, I can check the main node's boxes to select its sub-nodes. Next, to make the nodes editable, I need to define a Boolean variable, allow node editing with the value true, and assign this variable to the allow editing property. Then, I plan to bind local JSON data source to the TreeView component for the purpose of editing. So, let me assign this data source fields object to the fields property. Look at the output page now. You can edit the nodes by double-clicking on them. Finally, I will show you how to drag and drop items in the TreeView component. To drag and drop items, define a Boolean variable, drag and drop nodes, and set its value to true. Then, assign this variable to allow drag and drop property. Now, I can drag and drop items and its sub-items like this. Let me summarize. We have seen how to add the React TreeView of Syncfusion to the React application. We saw how to bind local and remote data sources to the React TreeView component and how to enable checkboxes and edit nodes. Finally, we have seen how to drag and drop a node and select multiple nodes at a time. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.